Hey guys, my name is Kuyanche and welcome to episode 5 of my Applied Energistics 2 tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So, as you recall, last episode we started talking about how you're able to autocraft using an Applied Energistics network, with things like the, what's it called again? Molecular Assembler and the crafting CPUs over there. But today we are going to be talking about the next step in that process, which is auto-processing. So, of course, it makes use of a kind of a similar system, having to do with both the crafting CPU and crafting patterns, as you can see right here in these ME interfaces, though it works a little bit different than before. So, let's get started. So, for this demonstration purpose, I set up a couple of things right here, which I will quickly run you by what I did. So first of all, I got myself an ME controller, which is again the heart of the ME network. You should know that by now. If not, be sure to check out the episode where I explained it. Right here, I got myself one of these crafting CPU multi-blocks made out of two 4Ks, a crafting co-processing unit, and a crafting monitor. It's pretty much the general design that I pretty much always go with, so that is pretty cool. Then right here, I got pretty much two lines of two separate things that I want to show you guys. Which is, first of all, thermal expansion machines. So this is pretty much one of the things that, in my opinion, I always want to automate first, which is, of course, smelting, pulverizing, induction smelting, and even automating the magma crucible and the fluid transposer. Yes, that is also possible. So, just as we would do with the molecular assembler, pretty much what you do is you attach the ME interface to the, for example, in this case, a redstone furnace, which we set the input to be the side with the ME interface. So in this case, the back side of the furnace is the input of this block. Then we also need an output, because this thing doesn't automatically know that it is or supposed to accept items, because this thing does not push items. So what we did is I set the top to be the output side, and I connected an ME import bus into this, which, as you should know, ME import bus imports items from the world to your network, and an export bus exports items from your network to the world. So that's something you definitely need to keep in mind. And then, just like before, what I did is I created a pattern, which is the encoded pattern which you make in the ME pattern terminal. But for this, I use the separate or the second option. So first of all is the regular crafting grid. But if you hit the crafting pattern right here, it will switch to processing pattern. And what you're able to do here is specify custom recipes. So in this case, what I specified is one cobblestone will give you one stone. Then what you do is hit encode, you'll get the pattern, and all you have to do is put it in the ME interface. And that is pretty much all you have to do for the very basics of processing. Just as easy as that. So let me quickly set to craft. Let's say craft myself 4 pieces of stone. You'll see available 4 cobblestone in my network. And to craft 4, so automatic, hit start. And you will see what it should have done is automatically put the cobblestone into the redstone furnace, and the ME import bus is automatically taking it out again and putting it into the network. Do keep in mind, of course, you do have to power these things, so I do have a separate power line running underneath this, because power transfer is something I have not yet shown you guys, which is something I will probably discuss later. That is pretty cool. As you can see right now, we got ourselves a lot more stone in our network. Pretty sweet. Then, of course, the same deal with the pulverizer. I set the backside to be input and the top to be import or output of this output of the pulverizer and import of the network. Then an ME interface to set one cobblestone will give you sand. But also keep in mind that this thing will have a second chance to give you gravel. And of course a lot of other products if you decide to pulverize other things. So just setting it to this, both sides being able to output, and one import bus will do all the outputs into your network, as long as it has these spaces, of course. So that is definitely something you have to keep in mind, that you have enough storage. Then what I got right here is an induction smelter. The induction smelter is pretty much the machine that makes alloys. Same deal right here, just set your custom recipes. For example, you get 3 invar ingots with 2 iron and 1 ferrous. which is again pretty easy, just, you know, drag and drop it right here. And then what I can do is craft myself invar automatically. For example, let's say I want 6 invar, and what it should do is automatically put the required items in this thing. Pretty awesome. Of course, if you think this is too slow, the speed it's getting imported into the network, you can always get yourself some acceleration cards and put it into the import bus, which is the part that actually imports it again into the network, and that is pretty cool. To keep in mind with stuff like this is, when you want to do multiple recipes at a time, it kind of goes wrong with backlogs, for example with the redstone furnace and the pulverizer, but it can go even more horribly wrong with the induction smelter. Because, of course, the pulverizer only has one input, and so does the furnace, but the induction smelter has two. So there is a chance that when you try to craft two different things at a time with the same smelter, that is trying to put part of both recipes in it, and then of course your system will be clogged. So what I recommend doing, which is a little bit more expensive, is get one induction smelter per recipe that you want to add to your network. I know it's expensive, but it is definitely foolproof doing it that way. Then again, yeah, you are also able to automate things like the magma crucible and the fluid transposer. This is a bit more of a expensive system, as you really need to dedicate something like this. So to set this up, let me quickly get some redstone. Because in this situation, I pretty much configured the recipe to B. Did I even configure? No, I didn't even configure anything to be in there yet. But you can, if you want to, for example, make redstone energy conduits, which are made like so. These. Pretty much what you do is you get the stabilized redstone into a redstone energy flux ducts in a fluid transposer. But, of course, that will mean that you need to actually have some destabilized redstone in this thing. So how did I manage to do that? It's easier than you think in this situation. All I did is, first of all, I'll talk about the magma crucible. All I did is I hooked up an export bus to this magma crucible to pretty much say, always export redstone to this crucible. So make sure you have a dedicated crucible for this setup, because any redstone that I put into this network will automatically be set to here. Unless, of course, this thing is full and then the rest it will just keep in the network. Then, of course, I set up the crucible to import from the back and output the destabilized redstone to the side. Then on the fluid transposer, I got two inputs. First one being on the side, which is for the liquids in this case, and one for the input, which is for the back, which is where you actually configure the recipe. And then of course, one more output, which is an import bus. So as you can see, if I would drop some redstone into my ME network, this thing will automatically export it into the magma crucible and turn it into destabilized redstone to make use of this fluid transposer. So that is something I usually also set up, which is dedicated magma crucibles for recipes like the destabilized redstone, enderium, glowstone, stuff like that. Pretty cool. Of course, you can also, you know, without actually crafting, automate some other stuff like the coke oven from Realcraft. The coke oven pretty much is a device that you put coal in and it creates creosote oil and cool coke. So all you really need to do is hook up an export bus to this thing, set it to export coal, and this thing will pretty much automatically know, like, okay, I got some coal in the network, I am supposed to put it into this coke oven. And then if you want to also take out the coal coke, all you have to do is hook up an import bus to this thing and set it to take out the coal coke, of course. And then you still have to find a place for the creosote oil, but that's a totally different story. You are able to store liquids with an Applied Energistics 2 add-on called Extra Cells, but I will be talking about add-ons a little bit later in this series, as I first of all want to discuss the main mod itself. Then there is another small little setup that I usually make in my network, which is when you want to keep a specific amount of items supplied. So what I already showed you guys is how you can craft stuff on demand, but what if you pretty much always want to have a specific amount of items in your network? For example, let's say, what did I set up here? Let's say 16 sand and 16 stone. Yes, that is, you know, a perfectly reasonable thing to always want to have in your system. Maybe even a bit more, of course. So what I did is I hooked up some smart cabling on one side of the interface. And on the other side, I hooked up an ME storage bus. The storage bus pretty much says to this block or to your network, like, okay, whatever content is in this interface, I want it to also be accessible in this network. Then what I did is I added a crafting card, which pretty much allows the ME interface to craft things in your network to keep the amount of items supplied. So that is pretty awesome. So what I can do is if I would take out, let's say, all this stone, what it should do is fulfill the request in a second, which this crafting monitor should show in theory. It may take a moment to actually catch up, but it should, if it has the materials, that is. It may, I'm out of cobblestone. That may be the issue, that it isn't trying to fulfill it. Let's put some more cobblestone in this. Ah, there we go. Now you can see the system is busy crafting. Do keep in mind that when it's trying to supply this crafting, a CPU is busy. So you're not able to auto-craft anything manually at this time, unless, of course, you have multiple of these multi-blocks set up. Pretty cool. So all that is done right now is the redstone furnace is automatically being turning cobblestone into stone. The stone is being imported into the network, and the ME interface is putting that stone into this ME interface to keep that 16 stone supplied. Pretty awesome. So that is a good way to always keep a specific amount of stuff in your network. Pretty awesome. And with that, guys, I think it would be a good wrapping up point. I definitely hope you guys found it educational, and like always, if you have any suggestions on what you would like to see me cover next episode or any further episodes, be sure to let me know down in the comment section or the forum link in the description. I always read all your comments and reply to them when possible, so keep that in mind. So thanks for watching, please leave a rating, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.